war, this area was a free African territory. Can you feel the energy of this space? It was a center for abolitionist activity and education and food. Specifically, in 1851, a white female abolitionist decided to open what was called a school for colored girls at a time when slavery was still legal in D.C. Myrtilla had vehemently and outwardly opposed slavery her entire life. She started her school in the North because where she was teaching previously in Mississippi, it was illegal to teach enslaved Africans. Despite all odds, in 1851, Miner began the school for colored girls on this site with just 6 pupils, which grew to 40 pupils within 2 months. Early funding came from Dr. Galileo Bailey, the white editor of the abolitionist newspaper, and Harriet Beecher Stowe, the white female author of arguably the most popular and controversial novel of the 19th century, Uncle Tom's Because of white opposition to what Miner was doing, she had to change locations every 6 months or so. Her school was a national model for African-American teachers. By 1858, 6 former students were teaching in schools in Ireland. DuPont Circle continued to be a place for education for African-Americans, with another school opening at 17th and N Street, the old Quaker meeting house, and yet another at Union Bethel Church at M Street between 15th and 16th. DuPont Circle continued that legacy of being a site for education of African Americans even after the abolition of slavery in 1862.
Skin yourself, girl. Not singing me love. I never told you for anybody else.
In 1863, the Miner School was granted a charter by the U.S. Senate to become the Institution for the Education of Colored Youth. Frederick Douglass sat on the Board of Trustees. Today, black women are among the highest educated in America. I tell you this story as we embark together as participants in a blessing ritual. For any white abolitionists and allies amongst us, I place this charge upon you that you would be fearless in areas where you don't stand against racism, just like Myrtilla Miner, that you would build tangible equity, that you would dismantle systemic racism. To my African-American sisters, take in the blessings of this ritual and continue to pursue your highest level of excellence. Accept this charge upon your hearts that here, beneath DuPont Circle, we can sow a collective seed of equity that will birth a new tangible era of equity and equality for all in Washington, D.C.